am a god.
Jennifer's Body is a film, which was released back in 2009, written and produced by Diablo Cody, featuring actress Megan Fox. This movie is known to be a movie that was ahead of its time, which was why it received such bad critics. However, it can also be argued that it was mismarketed to a bunch of male audiences, instead female audiences, which is why this movie was viewed so negatively by the male gaze, since it's a movie that empowers women and belittles men that tend to have misogynistic views. Jennifer's Body was used as a weapon, not a toy. The body that was victimized and violated by the evil group of men. In return, she destroyed men that were a threat to her in order to gain power. The jock was her first target since he was a threat to her popularity. The next person was Colin Gray, who was a threat to her closest female friendship. Her friendship with Needy. Needy always had a little crush on Colin and Jennifer didn't like it. She just wanted Needy for herself and maybe had feelings for her. Even though Jennifer was a hot popular cheerleader, this goes against the societal stereotype of a popular girl. The last person Jennifer killed was Chip, Needy's boyfriend, who was the last person getting between their friendship. This film was used against the predominant male gaze, since the monstrosity of female sexuality was consistent in this film. The idea of men being eaten by a demonized ultra-feminine woman didn't appeal to them because they were so used to having superiority in the history of horror cinema and the industry as a whole. Traditionally, horror films were invaded by male directors where everything was approved through the male gaze. This movie was created by female directors that gave a sexually appealing actress Megan Fox the main role. At that time, Megan Fox was known to be in Transformers, a movie which was filled with male fantasies, and it was depicted through the male gaze. After that movie, she was known to be an actress that fulfills men's desires, which was why she was so perfect for this role. Men were shocked when they saw her going against the things men were waiting for her to do. For example, instead of taking her top off for men, her body was weaponized to destroy the men that were problematic. Jennifer uses female magnetism as a sexual force that's used against men, embracing the idea of using sexuality as a weapon. By weaponizing the sexuality of a woman, it turns the usual female stereotypes around and uses them against the male audiences and empowers the female audiences. The only streamy scene in this movie is when Jennifer kisses Needy right after she kills another boy. This scene demonstrated a pure expression of their feelings for each other and demonstrates Jennifer only reveals her vulnerability to Needy. Though their friendship is known to be quite toxic, because Jennifer always wants Needy to be in her shadow. Her feelings for Needy was always there, but she is confused like every other teenage girl, so she chooses to ignore her emotions and move on with her life. When Jennifer says, "We can play boyfriend and girlfriend like we used to," suggests that their friendship has always had this sort of intimacy, which they were too afraid to say to each other. This scene is not supposed to appeal to men. Men are rendered pointless in this scenario, unimportant and unnecessary to achieve sexual pleasure. This idea of women expressing themselves sexually and using their power against men is completely appalling to the patriarchal society. This movie powerfully depicts that Jennifer is this beautiful, bisexual teenage girl that struggles with patriarchy. Her frustration was taken out by killing men. After being abused by a group of evil satanists, she felt frustrated that night because she wasn't strong enough to protect herself against those group of men. Jennifer felt so power hungry that night, so she started attacking men to feel powerful. After that night, her opinion of men became very low. She was so outraged that she decided to take her frustrations out on the gender that did her wrong. The gender gender that victimized and violated her. She mainly attacked men that were her potential threat because she didn't want to be made vulnerable again, especially by men. In the end, this movie demonstrates that Jennifer is a sexually empowered woman that intimidates the male self, and therefore it is seen as something to frown upon. A sexually empowered woman is a danger to the misogynistic culture and is seen as monstrous to those it threatens to dethrone. Jennifer's sexuality is monstrous because it threatens to wreck patriarchy by being its authentic, alluring self.